So, hi all, welcome to the part 5 of what's new in NAV 2017. In this particular video, we'll discuss enhancement, very few small enhancement which are there in terms of sales and purchases in NAV 2017. So let's start with the enhancement on the sales and purchase setup, and then we'll take it forward. So let's go and open sales and receivable setup. So there are three fields that has been added. One is default item quantity, and the tooltip which we explained in the earlier videos tells us that if we set this field, it automatically sets the quantity field for the for the item number in the sales line as one if you set it to true. Then there is create item from description. That means you can start typing a description, and if the description does not match to an existing item, it system prompts you to create a new item. And the third one is allow document deletion before. So that is used while deleting the invoices and the credit memos. So the system will check the allowed date from the setup. So that's on the sales side, and we enable two of them. We'll see them. And the another one is on purchase and payable setup, which is for the purchase side. So there is only one field, which is allow documentation document deletion before. So that also enable to for checks to, before deleting a posted document before this date. If it is not there, it does not allow user to delete the posted document. So let's see the first two, which we discuss about the default item quantity and create item from description by creating a new sales order and seeing. And then we'll see something else which is there. So let's go to sales orders and let's create a new sales order. So while creating a new sales order, you need to key in the header information first, and once that is done, we'll go to the line part. So let's see, I select the number, I select a customer, and then I collapse this tab once the information is fed. Okay, so now the information is there, so I collapse that part. My sales header part is kind of over. Now if I try to select an item, and I can look up the item number from the list, right? And I set that field for filling the automatic quantity. It'll set it up is to one automatically, so that this can be purchased, right? So that's the one thing. The another thing is that can be used by some of the customer that who create item on the go. Let's say I'm saying testing new item on the description directly, and system does not find it, and I click and enter. It says that the item is not registered in the system, which is the testing new item. It cannot find it. So are you sure that if it exists in the system, then you say select an existing item. If you want to create a new item, you click on this and you click OK. System pops up the item creation wizard using the template which you discussed in the earlier video, and then you kind of create the item, and then it returns the item description over there, and it proceeds with the rest of the process. So let's say I create a new item, the number is generated, the item is there, the rest are filled from the template which we selected, and I click OK. So my item is created at the runtime, and the quantity is set to one. As you can see, the inventory is low as a pop-up. So those are the two things which are on the sales side, that you can set that quantity automatically, as well as you can create the item on the go. So this, this caters the need of a few customers which are there in the market. And let's see, if you are a technical, then you might be interested in how it is working. So let's see at the sales line. And the same feature is there for the purchase line, only the second feature, which is creating item on the go by putting a description and all. So what happens is when I'm typing a number and selecting an item number from the list, it automatically populating the quantity as 1. So that is somewhere using a function which should be somewhere here, which creates the line automatically. So if the type is item, there should be a function which populate that, which is this set default item quantity. So what this function does, it goes to the sales and receivable setup. If the default item quantity is 1, it validates a quantity to 1 and then it checks the availability. And the second one is in terms of description. We'll see it on the purchase side so that we don't need to repeat it. So if you go to the description field properties, now the table relation is specified for the description, which was not there till 2016, and it is same as of item number table relation. And what happens behind the scene is when you type in the description, the system goes to the particular master and then looks for the description which you typed in. If it doesn't find one, then it gives you a confirmation window, and then you kind of select an item and all. So that's the first thing on the sales and the purchase. There's one other thing which is introduced in terms of sales, and we'll see that now. So let's go back to the department, go to the sales. Now this new thing which is on the sales is available from Microsoft at the sales code as well as at the sales invoice. On the others, you can add it as a technical. If you are a technical, then you know at the back of the tables are same, right? So if I go ahead and try to create a new sales code, it pops up the screen something like this. So let me try to minimize this so that you guys can see it. Okay, so I select a customer number and I collapse this and I say, let's say item 1000. Okay, cancel. I expanded one more zero and I say quantity is 1 because my thing is there, right? So my setup is done like that. But if you see, there is a huge block for work description, and this is a unlimited kind of text which you can type, like let's say this field accept data without a limit. And as a technical, the limit is 2 GB, but that's nothing that you need to worry about. And this should move to the poster documents also. So now if I move the cursor out of this, what happens at the back end is it actually gets stored on a blob field. We'll see it technically. And then let's say if I can create an order or an invoice from my sales code screen. So let's say I create an invoice. So now that particular information is transferred to my invoice, including my new field which is there. So this is my invoice which is created from that particular sales code. Now let's try to post it. Okay, so this particular work description does not go to your ledgers. Okay, I have a text area code missing, so let me specify that. I'll say non-taxable. Okay, and I can post it. Okay. So what I was saying is this work description does not go to your ledgers like GL, item ledger, or value entries and all, but it goes to your posted invoice. So once your document is posted, you can the information still remain on the posted document. You can see it here. So this this caters the need of some of the customer which wanted to add more information to their orders and the invoices related the job which is there. Till 2016, we used to use comments, and then they need to put it into multi-line and all those things. So this particular field, which is work description, allow user to put multi-line data, which can be seen on a post document. Let's go back and see how it is, actually done at the back end on the table level. So what happens is there is a field work description which is of type blob, and we all know that it, the blob field have a limit of 2 GB. But what actually happens is there are two function on the sales at a table which get us need of this. One is set work description. That is when you are typing the description and when you are moving it out, it comes as a text and then stored. It write that text in a blob field and then add that blob field to the record. And the second one is a get work description. When a user loads a record which contain a work description, this function is called, which actually calculates your blob field, and if the blob field has the data, then it write it back to a text variable and return it back to that particular page. So if you see that particular thing is here, the work description on the sales code, and this particular is a variable of type text. And as we all know, now our text variables are of unlimited length. Yes, I'm saying variables, not table fields. Table field are still have a limit of 250 characters, but my text variables have an unlimited length. So what happens behind the scene is when I update it, that set function is called, and when a new record is called, open, it actually gets a work description using the another function which we seen earlier, that is get work description. So these are the two changes which I was able to figure it out that are there on the system. So they are on sales code, they are on the sales invoices. Once you post your invoices, they navigate back to your posted sales invoices. And that's all which I was able to find out the changes in terms of sales and purchase. Let me know your views as a comment to article. Yes, I'm pretty open to your comments, what you want in the next part, and what you need to me to cover on the next part. I'll be happy to do that. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.